Farah from B&WTek. Thanks for joining us for the second installment of our educational video series. Today we're going to be talking about transmission. So Farah, can you tell us a little bit about transmission?
Sure. In optics, transmission is defined as the percentage of light that passes through a medium or a substance without interfering with it. In spectroscopy, we actually measure transmission as a function of wavelength. And that way we can characterize the different material, optical or physical properties of different materials.
Okay, great. Can you give us a little overview of the demonstrations that we have set up?
Sure. What we're going to be demonstrating today is the transmission through this glass pane. Mm-hmm. And a second experiment, this would be in the UV visible and a little bit of the NIR. And the second experiment is the difference between the transmission properties of the oil and the water.
Okay. Let's start with the glass pane that we have over here.
Sure. Just to describe the setup, what we have here today is a tungsten deuterium light source.
And why the tungsten deuterium? Why is that important to have both?
That's actually a very good question, because we just spoke about emission spectroscopy in the last video. So as we know, tungsten, the emission spectrum for tungsten really just falls off at about 300 nanometers. So what we use is another material, which is deuterium, which has a really nice emission spectrum in the UV from 200 to 400.
Okay.
So that is then connected to an adjustable cuvette holder, which we've modified a little bit. We've taken this part out, and when we can do, and we do that, you can actually accommodate larger samples like this glass pane. That then is connected via another fiber patch core to the Exemplar Plus spectrometer, which is the top of the line spectrometer that we have. We have a grating here which goes from 190 to 1100 nanometers. So like I said, it covers the UV visible and a little bit of the near infrared spectrum.
Okay.
What I'll be doing first is taking a dark scan, like we did in the video for emission. Mm-hmm. But in this case, the Exemplar Plus has a shutter built in. So when I just hit the collect dark spectrum button over there, the shutter automatically drops and you can collect a dark scan even under illumination conditions.
Okay, now why is that important? Why can't we just block the light as we did last time?
Well, sometimes it's just not possible to switch off the light source, so you're always under illumination conditions. And one more thing is that you can collect a dark spectrum without interfering with the alignment of the fibers and
okay.
The cuvette holder and everything. So, as you see, I just collected a dark spectrum. And now what I'll be doing is actually taking the glass pane out from here. And if you could just hold that.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be collecting a reference spectrum.
Okay. Now, I understand why we do the dark scan, but what's the point of a reference scan?
Okay. So, as I mentioned earlier, transmission is the percentage of light that passes through a medium or a substance. So, in the absence of a medium, you'll have 100% transmission.
Okay.
Now, to actually measure the transmission through a medium, you need to calibrate the spectrometer so that it measures 100% transmission first. So, you collect a reference to do that, and now, if I put the glass pane back in,
mm-hmm.
and then I'll collect a single acquisition, as you can see, we had 100% transmission initially when we collected the reference throughout the spectrum. Now it's 0% transmission in the UV region. So we can deduce from that glass is actually 100% opaque in the UV region, or this glass pane, for instance,
okay.
is 100% opaque. in the visible region, you can see almost about 90% transmission,
mm-hmm.
and that makes perfect sense because on an average, there's about 4% reflection per surface. So in this case, we have two surfaces of this glass. And so there's 8% reflection. And we can see a spectrum of about 90%. So because this glass is a little bit thicker, it's actually absorbing a little more light than usual. So we see about 90% transmission through this. In the NIR, it sort of falls a bit. But we're not too worried about the NIR or the UV for this particular glass because we only want to characterize only want to see the transmission spectrum in the visible region.
Okay. Now you mentioned before that you said I think 4% reflected on each side. So is that why when I look through a window, I can actually see my reflection?
That is exactly why. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, and we'll talk a bit more about it in the next video, which is on reflection. So we'll talk in detail about that.
Great. So let's move on then. I guess to the NIR demonstration.
Sure. Just to go over all the different components that we have to run this demonstration. We have a constant current tungsten halogen light source.
Now, why constant current? What's important about that?
Well, if you didn't have constant current, the current would be fluctuating. And with the fluctuating current, your signal would actually move up and down, and so your data would be a little bit skewed.
Okay.
So the second piece of the puzzle is the cuvette holder, which is actually a two-port cuvette holder. And then it is all connected via, again, a fiber patch cord to our SOL 1.7 spectrometer, which in this case covers a spectral range of 900 to 1700. So it's a little bit more than, we're getting into more of the NIR than the Exemplar Plus.
Okay.
again, very simply, what I'm going to do is collect the dark spectrum. And after we've done that, if you don't mind switching on the light source for me, and also putting in the empty cuvette and the cuvette holder for a reference scan.
So for this reference scan, we have to put the cuvette in there because we don't want to, when we measure the water and the oil, we don't want to include the cuvette in the measurement. Is that right?
That's exactly correct, yeah. When we take a reference scan with the empty cuvette in there, that takes into account any interference that would come from the cuvette itself. So
okay.
When we measure the oil or the water, we're only measuring the transmission spectra for the oil or the water.
Okay.
So I'll take the reference scan for that, and then as you see again, the transmission goes to 100%,
mm-hmm.
And then if you were to remove that and put in the water or the oil. And if I were to ask you a quick question, Stephanie, at this point, which one of the two do you think will be more transmissive, the water or the oil?
I would assume that the water would be more transmissive because you can see through it, it's clearer.
Well, put it in, let's find out.
Okay. And there's the water.
So if I take a single acquisition, you can see that the spectrum of water, it's almost opaque for the most part in the NIR spectrum. And if you were to take a single acquisition for the oil now.
Okay. Take out the water and put in the oil.
Mm-hmm. I'll take a single acquisition again. And this time we find out that oil is actually much more transmissive than water.
Yeah.
So yeah, so you were absolutely correct by saying that water would be more transmissive. Because in the visible region, the water is more transmissive than oil.
Mm-hmm.
But as we saw in the NIR, oil actually becomes more transmissive than water.
Okay. So other than these demonstrations here, can you tell us a little bit about real-world applications for transmission?
Sure. One of the basic applications of transmission is to characterize different optical components, like lenses or filters or mirrors.
Mm-hmm.
Another application would be in like the fermentation industry, for example, where they would take transmission spectra at different time points to measure the optical density of the mixture so that they can perform either QC or process monitoring of the fermentation process itself.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much again for your time today, and be sure to stay tuned for our next video on reflection. Thanks.